Come on, big 100. 18. Huh. Oh, hey guys. Welcome to the basement. This is a quick update video just to make sure that I've got everyone straight on what my expectations are for the assignment that is due this Friday, which is the learner portfolio reflection. Okay, so the learner portfolio, that's what you set up with a link for Tuesday's class. And just drop that link off in the Google form so that when I start checking to see if portfolios are complete and I click on that link, it takes me to your portfolio, and unit by unit, I can check for completeness. Now, at least one student asked me a really good question about where things need to be turned in. And what I need is, in order for me to be able to use the learner portfolio rubric, the one that I used in class to grade the models together, that is a Google Classroom rubric. So in the assignment that is due for Friday, this is assignment L.1, Unit 1, Learner Portfolio Reflection, please do turn in a Google Doc to that assignment that is your 300 to 500, 500 to 600 word reflection. That's because that Google Doc is going to be graded as a separate thing against that rubric that we worked on together on the model. Your reflection also needs to be posted to your learner portfolio so that your portfolio can be marked as complete. For this first semester, that's part of the learner portfolio reflection grade, easy 5 points if your portfolio is complete. What does a complete portfolio look like? It looks like a assessment at least. So in this unit, that's your Things Fall Apart paper is going to be in there. Either a copy of it is in the folder, or it is embedded in your Google site if you do that, or linked to if you do another style of website. It will have this reflection that you're working on now. So that ends up showing up in two places, both on the portfolio and then in Classroom, so I can actually grade it. And then the third thing is going to be an extract. And depending on what class you were in on our in-person day, you saw me go, that's something we need to do as well. I'll cover it in the last 2 minutes. And then I realized how crazy that would be, because we haven't actually talked about why and how to pick an extract. So I said, scrap it. And so that is still true. We will talk about extract selection on Friday, and we'll make it a part of that class, because it shouldn't take us too long. It's just going to involve cracking open Things Fall Apart. You'll need to take a picture with your phone or prepare to make a photocopy, or if you have a PDF copy, that could be another option. We'll talk about that on Friday, because I still swear I'm saying scrap it on the extract. And I'll change the deadline to the end of the day on Friday, 2:35, so that after that, I can go in and check that portfolios are complete and know that it has all three. The assessment, which in this unit is the paper, the reflection, which is what you're working on now for Friday, that has to show up in two places, portfolio and classroom, so I can grade it, and then the extract, which for now, you're scrapping, because I'll talk about it on Friday. So I hope that sets everybody straight. It's honestly not that complicated. It's just the fact that learner portfolio and learner portfolio reflection are two different things, and they have very similar names because one appears on the other. And so I recognize that you could have your head swimming a little bit, and I hope that sorts it out. Hope you are having a productive targeted instruction Wednesday. I'm going to upload this as soon as I turn off the camera, because I figure today is probably the day when a lot of you are trying to knock this thing out to have a nice, easy end of your week. And I'll see you Friday.